So my name's Stuart Reid, and I'm Executive Director of Community Foundation Grey Bruce, with our head office here in Owen Sound, serving the Grey Bruce region. And we are still very active during the impacts of COVID-19 and the pandemic. Like everyone else, our office is closed to the public, but we're still working. And in response to the pandemic, the foundation was considering its engagement with charities and not-for-profits across the region. And we moved our spring granting deadline from March to June, thinking that it would give organizations a bit more time to respond. And when we did that, we heard back from people saying, we're still out there, we're still working, we need support. And so we have been listening to that. And last month, we undertook a survey of all of the not-for-profits and charities that the foundation supported with a grant over its existence. We sent out a survey to them asking them 10 questions about how they were coping in terms of the effects of the pandemic and the closure. And we heard back loud and strong, some great responses that sort of give us a picture of how the frontline charities and people working on projects are faring across our region. First of all, it was a really great response to the call. We had 82 survey respondents out of, I think it was just a couple of hundred. So that's a pretty good uptake in terms of people being able to take the time to respond to our questions. And we heard from people right across Grey County. There were 28 of agencies that served Grey and Bruce counties. Owen Sound, of course, was the largest, and we had 11 respondents from Owen Sound. And then there was a smattering that go all the way from Hanover, North Bruce Peninsula, South Bruce, Kincardine, Huron-Kinloss. So we had a really good uptake in terms of that. What we found out was that 49% of the respondents are a registered charity. So that was interesting to us because we only fund registered charities or qualified donees. We also discovered that most of the respondents, which was more than 54, about 86%, have only 1 to 10 employees. So when we're talking about charities and not-for-profits across Grey Bruce, they're smaller organizations with not a lot of employees, not a lot of overhead. We also found out that 100% have volunteers engaged with their organization, and 30 respondents, or about 36%, had between 20 and 50 volunteers. That was the majority. So we see organizations that are really community engaged, that are really relying on community support for their operation. So a lot of people are stepping up and volunteering time. And when we looked at the cross-section of what types of organizations were responding, arts and culture was the number one with 24 respondents, followed by health and wellness. And then we had all the rest were kind of even between youth and children's well-being, social services, education and lifelong learning, recreation and sports. And then we had a couple that were also dedicated to the environment or environmental causes. So a pretty good cross-section of organizations in the region. And we also asked them, what was the impact that the COVID-19 pandemic was having on their organization so far? And people answered sort of a checklist. And the number one response was that they were closed. And so 49 of the respondents, or over 60%, are presently closed due to the pandemic. There was also an interesting number that there were 7 respondents who said that they were busier than normal and able to keep up with the demand. And some of the respondents, 4 of them, were overwhelmed by the increased needs from the community. So even though things are shut down and a lot of us are working from home and things are not normal, charities and not-for-profits that are performing services for our community are still out there working. And of course, in these times, vulnerable populations really require help because they're the most affected. And so some of those charities are quite overwhelmed by the need that's being expressed in the community. So we also asked them what are some of the challenges the organization is currently dealing with. And again, we had a checklist, and the top response was the cancellation of events and the inability to fundraise was number one. So 71 of the respondents, almost all of them, And so that's the high. 87% said that the cancellation of events was really impacting them greatly. And we all know in our community, you know, events where the community comes together to raise dollars for our charities is a mainstay of how they support their operations. So the pandemic, which limits public gatherings, has really impacted charities and not-for-profits quite tremendously. Next to that, 34% of the respondents said that they were experiencing financial difficulties, as could be expected, related to the cancellation of events and fundraising. And they also talked about the infringements upon their operations. And 19 of the respondents said they had difficulty trying to maintain support for their clients in this time. And that's probably due to, you know, social distancing and some of the PPE that's required in doing work these days. So that was heard loud and clear as well. Another anecdotal question that was pretty interesting. We asked them, what is the biggest unmet need in the community right now or going forward? And we heard a lot of different responses and trying to cluster those. We heard a lot of the things about health related, particularly mental wellness in face of the pandemic. We heard about concerns about job loss and loss of income, concerns about food security in our region, lots of concern about loss of support or activities for the clients they're serving. So they are really witnessing people that are being challenged by the impacts of the pandemic. And they also expressed concern about their own loss of momentum in terms of their engagement with the public and their fundraising efforts, you know, how they're going to step in, get back to work, and really ramp up to previous levels of activity. And the last question we asked was, what ways do you think your organization will be affected in the long term after COVID is concluded? And that was pretty interesting, asking people to look into the crystal ball, because we all have questions about that. We know that fundraising events are going to be canceled. That was something everyone said. They knew that they were going to have to revamp or change the way that they do their business, and that they were going to have to grapple with financial difficulties, and that the possibility of closure was looming in the future if things didn't change. So they also talked about the difficulty in keeping volunteers and staff because of social distancing, like the problems of working together with the restrictions that have been imposed. And probably most predominantly, people are concerned about the unknowns in our future. And I think that that's something that's kind of universally held right now. So all in all, we were really pleased with that sort of response. It gives the Community Foundation a great deal of insight when we try and grant strategically to help charities in our region. And it also helps us be a better advocate for that sector when we're talking with our community partners, with donors, with fund holders, and also with local governments, which we do frequently too. So we hope to be a good friend and a good advocate for that sector, you know, and to keep in touch with them as the events unfold over the months ahead too. We're a philanthropic organization, so we exist to issue grants back to the community. We work with endowed funds, which are monies or that have been invested with us by communities or individuals or agencies. And what we do is we invest the money. We never touch the capital. We only spend the interest, which is made in the marketplace. So we grant back the interest that we make on our endowed funds every year back into the community. In terms of impact, 2018, almost $750,000 was granted back to the community. Since inception, and the Community Foundation celebrating 25 years this year, since we were established in 1994, we've granted over $4.5 million back to Gray Bruce. So we're an interesting model of a business, and because we continue to grow and endowments can continue to grow as well, and that gives us more granting power and more community impact. We also are really engaged in understanding community well-being, much like the survey I've described, but we also undertake a lot of work in terms of vital signs, which is our report that looks into how we're doing as a community in terms of a number of indicators of wellness. And if people are interested, they should visit our website at communityfoundationgraybruce.com. And we have a couple of vital signs reports there if you're interested in seeing some of our report backs on well-being in Gray and Bruce counties. We have a deadline coming up June 15th for community grants. And so those are for projects and programs that charities and not-for-profits are undertaking in the community that support all aspects of community life. So please look at that on our website. The application is live. I also want to say that the Community Foundation is collaborating with United Way Bruce Gray on administering the Emergency Community Support Fund, which is $350 million that was set aside by the federal government that's rolling out across Canada to support charities and not-for-profits that are servicing vulnerable populations that are dealing with COVID-19. So locally, we have over $500,000 that we're going to be dispersing. Applications are open now, and you can apply either through the United Way or the Community Foundation. And there is information on the application process on our website. And it's a rolling deadline. So we are, every week, we're administering more and more grants up until the end of July. That's our window for the granting period. But I encourage people to look at that as well. Very important funding that is going to assist with some of the things we discussed in our survey, too.